Today for the Bitcoin price with DaVinci J15. Believe it or not, but we are here once again in the jungle of Tulum. And I wanted to ask DaVinci, because we just had a crazy dump from 58,000 down to 45,000. Bitcoin is still stumbling around. And the most important question, of course, is, are we going to go lower? Well, a few hours ago, I already talked about my opinion. 120,000 people watched the video already. But I wanted to know DaVinci J15's opinion, because there are some informations in the charts which might be shocking for you Bitcoin holders. But we have some crazy news to share with you, so stick here until the very end. But before we are starting with the Bitcoin price, with what is actually likely to happen for Bitcoin in the immediate short term, our trades, our expectations, our price targets, I wanted to ask you, DaVinci J15, the most important question of today: how are you doing today, my man?
In the pot, 555, loving Tulum. Oh my goodness, it's nice and warm here. You know what, it's actually cold and chilly, right? The weather's dropped a lot. They're having the same problem that the Texans are having, but not as severe, thank goodness. I'm glad. So I'm glad to be here, sharing the knowledge that I've got, sharing my information with you guys, sharing it with Chris, spending time with Chris. We're having a great time.
Yeah, beautiful time, beautiful time. But I know that many people are right now very scared. And sir, can I help you? Okay, many people are right now very scared as what is happening in the Bitcoin markets right now, because we just dropped a lot, and many new people are actually joining the space right now, and they are not used to these dumps. I mean, we already experienced that, especially you, since 2011. I saw 45% drops within a bull market. Then we had in January, many people joined after January, but we had a 33% drop already. Now we dumped down nearly 24%. And the question is this already the end? Or are we going to drop lower? So first of all, my first question, DaVinci, do you think 45,000 is the end, or are you actually targeting another level quickly? My opinion is, if we are dropping lower, I think we are getting insane support at the $39,000 to $40,000 level, which is the golden pocket and also the bottom of the EMA ribbon. This is what I was talking about before. But what do you actually think, DaVinci?
Well, after the end of my last video, I did a complete analysis, and I thought, I saw that Bitcoin was probably bouncing at the $45,000 level and holding it. So I felt that we're gonna see another drop down there and then bounce from there. I remember you were telling me earlier today, oh my God, it's at $44,000, right?
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, but you know what? It's gonna bounce higher, and it has. It bounced back up to $48,000, and I think we're gonna see it probably bounce all the way to the 61.8 or something like that. We're gonna turn the tide. And have it, if we had some charts here, we're probably going to go turn the head up to the 13 EMA on the 4-hour candle. So look for that. And, you know, just look for your W's and M's, right, in order to help you follow the trade. The trend's probably heading upward, so that's what I would do. Look for W's on that.
This is one thing, and always, usually I say things don't change, because people say this time it's different and so on. In the end of the day, we know we are still going to experience a very severe bull market. Sir? Okay, just a few more seconds and we go. Okay, thank you.
Cinco minutos.
Gracias. In the end of the day, we will always experience a bear market. We will always experience big shakeouts in the markets. That's very normal. And what I think is different a little bit this time is that we have institutions putting confidence at specific price levels. And we just saw this massive dump to 45,000. Chart-wise, we are supposed to go lower. The 40,000 US dollar level is a very important one with a lot of confidence. But you just said we pumped from 40,000 to 45 to 48,000. One reason for that was the crazy news of Square actually buying 170 million US dollars worth of Bitcoin. What do you think about that, DaVinci?
Well, yes. I don't think that was actually, everybody's looking at that and considering that news is important. I was looking at it and saying, hey, you know what? It's going to bounce. And did that mean that the charts said that the news was coming out? I don't think so.
Exactly.
So
the chart said we go lower, right?
Right. The chart said that we're going to go lower and then bounce again. Yeah. So did the chart tell me that, hey, they were going to actually buy
$170 million
in Bitcoin? No, it didn't. It just said that, hey, we're going to bounce.
The whole world is watching.
So it's clear that, you know what, if you look at the charts, I could tell you the news.
Exactly.
Right? Yeah. That's a thing, right? And so I really don't think that that actually affected the price. I think this was this is just a way for people to really explain why the price bounced, yeah. Right? And that's it.
I mean, guys, you have to keep in mind Square, MicroStrategy, it's like two companies, but we have potentially thousands of companies jumping in. And just to remind you very quickly, MicroStrategy, Michael Saylor, they are standing on the sidelines right now with $1.05 billion. They already raised the money. And their purpose of this raise is buying Bitcoin. They are looking forward to buy Bitcoin, and they are probably already scaling in dollar cost average with Coinbase OTC desk. So please keep that in mind. If you are thinking about selling your long-term holdings, big billionaires are selling them from you guys. So this is what I wanted to tell you, buying it from you. Sorry. So let's say we have another 10% down. Do you really mind? Does it really matter so much in the long term? This is one of the most important purposes of that video. If you are thinking about selling, we actually have to leave already. Yeah. If you are thinking about selling your Bitcoin, keep in mind that big billionaires are actually going to buy it from you. Don't listen to people like Bill Gates or so. Gracias, señor. Don't listen to people like Bill Gates or so. Look at this beautiful Da Vinci. What do you think about that?
It's gorgeous view, man.
It's like the Zurich Hotel. Wow. Very, very beautiful. And yeah, the main purpose of this video was actually to tell you that we have billionaires on the sidelines. We have big people telling you that Bitcoin is speculative. It is volatile. Remember, JP Morgan taught you the same. Well, what did they do in the end? JP Morgan bought Bitcoin, and there's proof for that. So please, guys, Don't get too confused from the media. Don't get too confused when Bill Gates is telling you, wow, Bitcoin is shouldn't be bought by anyone who has less money than Bill Gates, than Elon Musk. Everyone has less than that. So yeah, let me know what you think about that. And yeah, okay, no problem. Anyway, I would say goodbye right now. Thank you everyone for watching. Thanks for watching until the very end. It got a little bit hectic here. Thanks for smashing up the like button. And yeah, leave your favorite altcoins down below. David, any last words to say?
Always play from a position of strength and do not get wrecked.
Do not get wrecked, guys. Thank you so much for watching. And yeah, as always, guys, we will see you in the next one of MM Crypto. And as always, guys, bye-bye.